Welcome to the introduction of the Master Geomatics for the Built Environment. My name is Bastiaan van Loenen and I am the Program Director of this Master Program. With this presentation, I inform you about the world of geomatics and the Geomatics Master Program. The geomatics domain concerns the science and art of collecting, managing, analyzing and visualizing geographical information. These steps of collecting, managing, analyzing and visualizing fit very well with what we do in the geomatics program. Here you see a graphical overview of the steps you follow during the program. At the very end, you can use the geographical information. But first, you will have to capture and store the data. After that, the data will be modeled. The fourth step is the data visualization and distribution. Only after a quality check has been performed for each step, the data can be used. In our program, we follow the exact steps I just described. Together, we call these steps the geoinformation chain. You will learn a lot with theory and practical assignments on positioning systems and a variety of data acquisition methods. You'll learn to model data in 2D and 3D and apply these models in practice. You will also learn the ins and outs of the geoinformation chain governance. I will now explain each step in more detail. Let me start at the end of the chain, the applications. Well-known examples of geomatics applications are Google Maps and the TomTom navigation systems. But geomatics is also about doing spatial analysis in 2D and 3D. For example, it allows you to assess the distribution of noise or carbon dioxide or nitrogen and the influence of buildings on this distribution. Or for assessing the energy potential of neighborhoods, it also allows you to determine urban heat islands and explaining the causes for these islands. You can also think of analyzing the extra shadow a new construction can cause. Finally, 3D analysis can be used to predict flood risks and the well-known solar potential of buildings. It is clear that there are many more applications you can think of. But we need geographic data for this. More precisely, we need data linked to a location. Positioning technology such as GPS or Baidu forms the core of the geomatics domain. It allows you to link a location to the data. In geomatics, we not only deal with GPS and Baidu techniques, but also with telecom or Wi-Fi technologies for indoor navigation, or even with processing technologies that compare localized images in a databank with the images your device creates on your location. What can you do with this information? For example, you can automatically categorize someone's travel pattern. What you see in this picture are GPS traces of people. The different colors represent the different ways of traveling. If you know where people or things are, you can also influence their behavior. For example, through crowd or fleet management. More extreme location information is used to seduce individuals to go to certain places, like a shopping mall or a specific restaurant. Geomatics is also about data acquisition, acquiring data from the built environment via, for example, remote sensing satellites or drones. This data is used to detect and classify objects in the built environment. With this data, we can also identify changes in a natural environment. For example, a few years ago, one of our students measured the melting of ice in the Arctic by comparing remote sensing data from different years. Another technology that is essential to our profession is laser scanning. A laser beam is sent to Earth, and by taking the time difference between sending and receiving the laser beam, you can measure the distance between the plane and the Earth. This allows you to capture the shape of objects, buildings, and landscapes. This slide shows an example of the Dutch digital elevation model that clearly shows the buildings of the Library of Delft University of Technology. And with the point cloud of the library, you can create a model in 3D that allows you to perform spatial analysis in 3D. Once the model has been created, you need to think about how you can visualize the buildings in the model and how and in what format users can obtain the model. Is this done via a download service, via an API or another service? In addition to non-dynamic data, such as the library's 3D model, we also teach you how to deal with real-time sensor data. A final step in the geoinformation chain is the governance of the chain. Here we pay attention to the legal issues, such as privacy and rights to access and use the data, and we pay attention to organizational issues, such as how to prevent that the same data is collected twice, and how to ensure that the data that is collected can be directly used in an existing GIS system. Now I will address the first and second year of the program and what kind of education you can expect. In the first year, we will focus on the core courses that are all linked to the geoinformation chain. We will also teach you how to program in Python and C++. In most of the courses, the theory is linked to practical cases, so you can immediately see the results and impact of your study. We have regular lectures in the classroom, but also online education, tutorials, and assignments. The assignments can be individual, such as writing a paper or a script, but you will also have to tackle practical problems through group work. This is especially the case in the synthesis project course, where you work in a group of 5 students on an assignment with a client from the commercial or public sector. You will present the results of the synthesis project to the participants of Geomatics Day, our annual networking event that attracts many people and gives you the opportunity to get acquainted with geomatics companies. In addition to the core program, you also have the opportunity to take subjects of your own choice. You can choose electives at our department or other departments in Delft or at another university. The electives we offer include an internship and an individual research assignment. Finally, you do your individual accreditation project on a topic of your choice. Of course, I have to mention our students' association, Geomatics, GEOS, in this presentation. For most of our students are a member of GEOS. GEOS organizes social and professional meetings in which all our students and staff members can participate. Finally, a brief insight in the careers of our graduates. As you can see, our graduates work for a variety of organizations. They are highly valued by large software companies and well-known universities, but also by small and medium-sized enterprises and local governments. In the period 2015-2020, almost all our graduates found a job at the appropriate level within 6 months. Finally, I would like to emphasize that geomatics is highly appreciated by our very diverse student population. But it is also a demanding and challenging study, especially if you do not have a background in mathematics and statistics. But if you are passionate about maps and are eager to learn computer programming and apply these skills to solve real-world problems, then you will certainly enjoy the geomatics program very much. On our website, you can find detailed information about the geomatics courses, about student work and student experiences. You can also contact us through email. Good luck in choosing the program that best suits your interests, and maybe we will meet in Delft in the Geomatics program. Goodbye!